نوين الأربعين، نوين الاعتكاف، نوين الخلوة، نوين العزلة، نوين الرياضة، نوين السلوك، نوين الصيام لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. It's live. It's not live. It says end stream. It's live. Maybe it's there's a lag. الحمد لله. طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is to be with good ones, and goodness is in such gatherings. It is said, مولانا الشيخ شهاب الدين نقشبند ويسير البخاري said this. If you see how attentive his students were, 12,000 times. They counted how many times. 12,000 صحبة يعني. Every صحبة he started, he would say, أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is صحبة. This is what we are missing now in this day and age. Is they taught people that you can go it on your own. And our religion is all about the jama'ah. It's all about the gatherings. It's all about finding people you deem nearer or dearer than yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being with them. And that's everybody if you're a murid in the tariq. Because you have to see yourself as everyone is better than you. And it is said, من لم ينفعك لحظه لن ينفعك وعظه. If you are with people whose gaze does not benefit you, their speech is not going to benefit you. And there's also, I think, a hikmah of Sayyidina Ibn Ata'illah. من لم ينهض بك حاله أو كما قال ها؟ لا تصاحب من تفضل من لا تصاحب من لا ينهض بك حاله. I'm not sure I got that part, but mainly don't accompany those who their state does not bring your himma, your aspiration up for good things. Sheikh?
Uplift you.
Yeah. Uplift you, not just uplift your aspirations, your himma. Because the people of today, we are all, our himma is for, yani most people, are their himma is for physical things, for dunya. What I like to wear, what I like to, what house I have, what degree I have, what our aspiration, what we're running for, what we're spending our life, our time, our energy, is only for materialistic, worthless things. They're worthless in the big scheme of things. We're not saying that for people not to try to attain a good, comfortable life, or maybe wealth and use it in Allah's way. No, that's not the point. But عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ This is the Nabi. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim used to say, and tonight we're gathering for the honor of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, whose urs is, I think, on the 8th of Rajab. He left this world in 2014. And he used to complain sometimes when we'd go with some of his senior deputies, and sometimes I was like a fly on the wall. I'm sitting there, people asking for tibin for sha'iris. They say they think we have a stable here. They come and ask for their donkeys, some food. يعني the Shaykh is sitting, the real Mashaykh, they are sitting with the order and permission and inheritance of سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And just like سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, his presence and power took people who and transformed them into something unimaginable. Took Bedouins, difficult, tough, rough, and then they became a'lam. They became something else. That suhba, that presence, that gaze, that fight that was coming on the gathering of Prophet ﷺ and on his person, took these people and made them into ashabi kan-nujum bi-ayyihim uqtadaytum ihtadaytum. My companions are like the stars. Anyone you take as a guide, they will guide you. 124,000 sahabi of Prophet ﷺ, they said, in Hujjat al-Wada', when they were all, they said that the companions that day were 124,000. Any one of them who had the sharaf, the honor of being in the presence of that nur, of that mercy, became something else, was transformed to be a star, a guide for humanity, a role model. That process still exists with his inheritors. And we've witnessed, those who are lucky to have met such people, witness when you come into the presence of such a one. Witness how your himma is shut up. You don't want to be in this dunya. I went with Sheikh Nazim in 2001 to Uzbekistan, 2000 before in May. Well, it's coming in May. It was an official trip, and we went 11 of our Grand Masters in Uzbekistan. Shah Naqshband, Mir Kulal, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Abdul Khalil Ghujdwani, Mu'allif Khatm al Khawajagan. These are the called is the Khawajagan is the masters. That's what it's a Persian word, dhikr of the masters. We went and visited with him. In my entire life, I had no reference. Everything I was experiencing, it's like it wasn't from this dunya. I've never experienced it in my life. And to be with him, the only thing you could maybe say is like you went into a different dimension. Like you died and went to another place. We spent with him 2 weeks in that trip, visiting awliya and maqams. And it was something astonishing. It was something non-worldly to be in his presence. Not because I was a yani younger than, I was a while back. So maybe I didn't understand much about religious realities or spiritual realities or any of that, but I was tasting and experiencing in his presence those things without understanding even. Why? Suhba. Suhbatul awliya. Suhbat ahlillah. This is what we need now. This is what our youngsters, they need to be inspired to raise their himma from things that are useless or of no benefit. They need to fall in love with something non-worldly. Sheikh Nazim had around him many, many of the murids from Europe, and from here and there would send their teenage boys and to stay sometimes in Cyprus, in Lefke with him. 15, 16, 17, 13 sometimes. You see all these youngsters staying at the dargah, they send them out to the farm to work. They're goofing around sometimes. And you, subhanAllah, all of them now, you see them, they're solid. They're solid in their religious, in their practice, in their certainty. Nothing will shake them off. Because you saw that relationship, they were in love with Sheikh Nazim. He would do hadra for sometimes, and sometimes he would ask people, there were some people from Europe, he would say, there were some brothers who came from break dancing. And Mawlana would be like, hey, do flips in the hadra. And some people from outside say, what is this? But they don't understand what is happening. These people became in love with a very special personality and a holy personality, dressed and inheriting from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from his light, from his mercy, from his manners. So when we used to go to be with Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, it is not the person. It is what he bodied with. It is what he represents. And so Prophet ﷺ said, pray as you see me pray. How? 1400 years. By being with that, with one who saw his Shaykh pray, who saw his Shaykh pray, who saw his Shaykh pray all the way to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How else are you going to fulfill this hadith? So that is the importance of finding, seeking, looking with sincerity for guidance. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens for people a way to be guided. And that is usually through His holy men. And back in the days when I would read the poetry of Mawlana Jalaluddin Rumi, and I read about his life, and he says that if a person sincerely in his heart asks
world, that is a principle, that is a law like gravity. With guidance, with prophets, with inheritance of prophets, not just books.
It's still on? Okay. Inshallah, we will we'll do a short dhikr, and then we'll do a maulid, a short maulid as well. And there's food, Sheikh Sayyid Ali?
No.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. And if you have yani also reading about this man, helps to see the struggles they went to. People today, we were talking in the car, you know, we're end of times people. And people today have a hard time understanding that it's not cheap to be mardi and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be entered into His heavens is not something small, and that the need to struggle against one's ego, against one's inclinations, against the attachments of dunya. That is something that everybody has been trained, that everything must be easy. But when you read the lives of these mashayikh, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, when you read what they had to struggle, when you read the Shaykh Abdullah Faiz Daghestani, 5 years seclusion, 5 years, Shaykh Nazim would maybe, I don't know how many times Mawlana Shaykh Abdullah put him in seclusion, sometimes 1 year, sometimes he would send him to Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani's maqam to make seclusion there, khalwat, in Medina 1 year, so forth. He would order him, go to Iraq, go to Turkey, by foot at that time. He would walk village to village. Why? Making da'wah. For what? أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ. You think it's going to be easy? You think you have, you're going to do it without struggling? That is, look at the life of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at how much difficulty he endured. Look at his inheritors. Look at his Sahaba. Alhamdulillah. يعني, we don't have to fight people with a sword, and we don't have to endure the things that they had to endure. But at least a struggle against your nafs to attend zikr, for example. This majlis and majalis like this, how many around? How many people attending? How many Muslims? Right now, how many people sitting on the TV, sitting on the internet, wasting their time with movies, with sports, with... We, yani, these majalis are priceless. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يختص برحمته من يشاء. Whomever He wants, He likes, He makes, gives him tawfiq. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad tawfiq to come back, to understand the importance of their Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their lives, in their spiritual lives, in the life of their children, to understand the esteem and high value of loving Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.